One, two, eyes on you.
Good morning, class. My name is Ms. Garcia. Today, we're going to be learning about rates and ratios. Please remember to raise your hands if you have any questions. First, we will be going over some vocabulary that we will be using during the lesson. As we are learning these new vocabulary words, I need you to write them down with the definitions in your math journal. The first term we have is ratio. Ratio is the comparison of two numbers or measurements. The next one is terms. The terms are the numbers or measurements being compared. They are called terms of the ratio. The next vocabulary word is rate, a special ratio in which two terms are in different units. Does anybody have any questions so far? Okay, let's proceed. The last term is unit rate. It has a denominator of one. Okay, so make sure you copy all these down. You might need, it might help you with your homework assignment to know what they are. Okay, so has anybody ever heard of rates or ratios before? Do you know that we use them in everyday life? Well, a ratio compares values. To keep it simple, we're going to ignore the units, which is the cost in dollars, in weights or ounces, or the units of weights or ounces. Okay, and we're just going to focus on the number part for a bit. For example, how does 3 compare to 6? Well, we can write a ratio. We'll write it in a ratio form. Okay. How does 3 compare to 6? The first way we can do this, and you guys can keep writing your vocabulary while you're listening to me explain this to you. The first way we can write a ratio is 3:6. The colon represents 2, the word 2, okay? Because you're comparing the two numbers. Then the second way we can do it is 3:6 with the word 2. The third way we can do it is like a fraction. It's 3:6, okay? This is called a fraction form. This is the form we will be using since it is math, okay? And I think it'll be a lot easier for you guys to write the ratio this way. Okay, so is everybody copying down your notes? And if you want, you can copy down the example. Now, there is one trick, and I wrote it in orange down here at the bottom so it stands out, okay? The trick with ratios is to always make sure you multiply or divide the numbers, okay, of the terms by the same value. So what you do to one side, you have to do to the other side. Okay, does everybody get that? So, we'll go ahead and go up here to math steps on how to work the ratios, okay? When you finish up with your vocabulary words here, and the ratios, okay, the sample ratio, we can go ahead and keep writing at the bottom of your math journal after the vocabulary words, we'll write the steps on how to work a ratio. So, like baking a cake, there's steps to baking a cake. So math has its own steps as well. These are the directions you're going to follow to work out the problem. The first step to work out a ratio is to read the problem, okay? Then you're going to identify the question, and you're going to write the expression using the information provided to you in either like the word problem or the written format, okay? The second step is going to reduce or simplify, okay, and the ratio. And you're going to do this by dividing all the terms in the ratio by the common factors, okay, until there are no more common factors between the two numbers. An important part about step number 2 and number 3, which I will go over right now, but another little trick and something you need to be on, have your eye out on all the time, is don't lose sight of the original quantities that led to the ratio in the first place. This is very important, okay? Number three, you need to double check. Number three says you can double check your answer by dividing it by the multiple or the common factor, okay, that you used to reduce it. You should come up with the original quantities that led to the ratio in the first place. Okay, that's the third step. And then the fourth one, that's why I said very important to remember the original quantities of the ratio, okay? Because when you double check it, you should come up with that original quantity. Number four is just to box your answer. By now, everybody's copied down the vocabulary words and the definitions, as well as the math steps for ratios, because now we're going to start talking about something called rates, which are a special type of ratio, okay? Rates are commonly used in everyday life, okay? Prices in the grocery stores and prices in department stores are some examples of rates, okay? Two important ideas are that a unit rate and a unit price, okay? A unit means that we have one of something. A unit rate means we have a rate for one of something, okay? Which is like, your unit can be like a t-shirt, okay? If you have a price for a t-shirt, the t-shirt is your unit. The unit price is the actual price of the t-shirt, okay? We write the rate as a ratio with a denominator of one. For example, if you ran 70 yards in 10 seconds, you would run an average of 7 yards in 1 second, okay? Both 70 yards in 10 seconds and 7 yards in 1 second are both rates, but the 7 yards in 1 second is a unit rate, okay? Why? Because you have already reduced that fraction of 70 over 10 equals, and we've reduced it, okay? Because 10 and 70 have a common denominator of 10. And when you do that, you get 7 over 1, which is 7 to 1, the ratio 7 to 1. So the next samples, like, this is for example, what is the unit price of 10 pounds of potatoes that cost $2.80? What we would do is we would divide 10 into 280, $2.80, okay? And our answer would be 28 cents per pound, okay? So you guys can copy these two just examples of my lecture down. And I will have some formal examples for you further into the lesson. Now we have math steps. As we did for ratios, we have math steps to figure out rates, okay? First, you need to read and identify the problem, okay? With the information given, you're then going to write the ratio, the rate in ratio form, okay? Make sure it's equal to the multiple unit rate with one as a denominator, okay? Which would be like your number over number equals number over one. This is the format you would use to write a rate and to figure it out as a ratio of the second term. If you're trying to figure out the unit rate or the unit price, you need to divide the unit price by the multiple number of units, okay? So that would go according here. So 10 pounds here in this problem would have been our unit, the multiple number of units. Because we have more than one unit, more than 1 pound, it's 10 pounds, okay? So this would be our multiple number of units right here, divided by the price, the price of the unit, okay? According to the type of question, divide as necessary. Now, there is one thing you have to remember. Once you figure out your answer of whatever the question is, whether it's the price per pound, okay? You need to make sure you do not forget to label the answers correctly, okay? So you might forget and you might put 28 cents, but you need to make sure you put 28 cents for what? It's per pound, That's what we're talking about. That's what it's asking you for. How many pounds, what is the unit price of 10 pounds of potatoes? So we need to make sure we label our answers correctly. And then lastly, you'll box your answer. Does everybody understand any questions? Okay, boys and girls, now on a blank sheet in your journal, as a continuation of our lesson, I want you to copy down these examples. These three problems are all ratio examples. Okay, we're gonna go over them. I'm gonna be going over them as you're copying them down. Okay, the first one says, a bag contains 60 Legos, some blue and some green. The ratio of Legos, of blue Legos to green ones is 1 to 5. How many blue Legos are there? Okay, so what I have to do here is I have to set the fractions equal, okay? I did 1/5 plus 1 in the denominator, so make it 1/6 times 60/1, okay? Then here, I did, on this side, the equal sign has to be the same as this side over here. So all these terms have to be equal, okay? So now we have 1/6 times 60/1 over here as well. Then I'm going to reduce or simplify the fractions, okay? So I found common factors between 60 and 6, which was 6, and I got 60 divided by 6 is 10, okay? 1 and 1, we don't have any more common factors on those two, so they stay as is. So on this side, my answer is 10 on the left of the equal sign. Now to the right of the equal sign, I'm going to figure out this over here. Since they're the same, 1/6 times 60/1, I did the same thing, the same factors as I did on the left side. So 60 divided by 6 is 10, and 60 divided by 6 is 1, okay? And my answer over here was 10. So on both sides, my answer was 10/1. These are equal fractions now. So when I took 60, now I know that 60 Legos, we have 10 blue ones, so I subtracted 10 blue ones, which is 50 green ones. That's just to provide further information, but the question asks, how many blue Legos are there? So my answer is gonna be, there are 10 blue Legos. This is the answer I'm going to box, and please notice I did label my answer appropriately, okay? Number two says, a checker club has 24 members, of which 5 are males, and the rest are females, okay? So we have 5 of the checker club members are boys, and the rest are girls. What is the ratio of females to all the club members, okay? So what I did was I took 24 club members total, I subtracted the 5 boys, okay, which leaves me a remainder of 19 girls, okay? The ratio would be 19 to 24. There are no common factors in between those two. I cannot simplify it anymore. So my answer would be, the ratio of females to all club members is 19 to 24. This is going to be my answer. This is the answer I boxed, okay? The last example over here says, Joe drew 21 hearts and 17 circles. What is the ratio of circles to all the shapes? What I have to do first, I have to figure out how many shapes there are total. So I added 21 plus 17, which is 38 shapes, okay? Now, they are asking, the question is, what is the ratio of circles to all the shapes? So how many circles do we have? 17. So my ratio is gonna be 17 to 38, okay? There is no more simplifying in this ratio. They have no common factors, okay? 17 is an odd number. The only multiples of 17 are 1 and 17. And that's what my answer would be. So the answer I'm going to box is the ratio of circles to the total number of shapes is 17 to 38. This would be my answer. I'm going to give you a few minutes to keep copying these problems and work out the problem as well, so you have it for further reference. Okay, boys and girls, we're gonna continue with our lesson. These are examples of rates. Just like the ratio problems, I want you to be writing them down so you can refer back to them. The first problem says, a 12-ounce can of carrots costs 69 cents. The rate is 69 cents per 12 ounces, okay? The question says, write the rate. So the first term is measured in cents, and the second term is in ounces. So our answer is very, this is a very simple question, is 69 cents per 12 ounces, or to 12 ounces. For every 12 ounces, it's 69 cents. So this is what your ratio should look like. Your first term is measured in cents, that's this right here. Your second term is the ounces, it's 12 ounces. That is your answer, you box it, and let's go to number two. Number two says, Jack works 60 hours every 3 weeks. At that rate, how many hours will he work in 12 weeks, okay? This one's a little bit more complicated, not very much. So we need to figure out how many hours he works in 12. They're only giving us the information of how many hours he works in 3 weeks, okay? So what we need to do is we need to write our first ratio, which would be 60 over 3. Remember, we're doing it in fraction form, okay? And we need to set it equal to a term, the second term of the denominator of 12, okay? Since we don't know how many hours he would work in 12 weeks, right now we're just gonna put an X there, okay? So if we look at 60 over 3, the bottom, I have a denominator here on the other side, which is 12. I need to figure out how do we get from 3 to 12? We have to multiply by 4, okay? So 3 times 4 is 12, okay? But remember, what I do to the bottom, I have to do to the top. So 60 times 4 is 240. That means my X equals 240, okay? So that is my answer. When I write it to box the answer, I'm not going to write the X because we've already figured out the amount X represents, which is 240 hours. I label my problem, and you box your answer, okay? So Jack works 240 hours in 12 weeks, okay? Let's proceed to number three. The third problem says a sign in a store says 3 pens for $2.70. How much would 10 pens cost? If 3 are $2.70, okay, how many would 10 be? Well, we have a couple more steps on this problem. First, we need to figure out the unit price. How much is each pen, okay? So if we can get 3 of them for $2.70, okay, we need to figure out, we do your math, okay, 3 goes into 27 9 times, and remember to put my decimal right there. Subtract 27, and then 3 times 0 is 0, that's 90 cents, okay? That is my price per pen, 90 cents per pen. Now, the question asks, how much would 10 pens be? So I gotta take 90 cents times 10 pens, and that gives me $9. So my answer would be 10 pens will cost $9. Okay, does anybody have any questions? I'm gonna give you a few minutes to keep copying that. Okay, class, now that everybody has finished up working on the practice problems, we're gonna go ahead and go over them together. I want you to pass your papers to the right, to the person on the right of you, and they will be grading. Make sure you are using a red pen to grade your paper. These will be a grade, okay? So let's go over the first problem. It says, William bought 2 fish tanks that have a capacity of 15 gallons and 30 gallons each, 2 different fish tanks, okay? It says, write the ratio of the capacity of the smaller tank to the capacity of the larger tank. And then it says, hint, hint, reduce to the lowest term, okay? So the first tank was 15 gallons, that's a smaller one. It says, and then to write the ratio to the second term, which is the larger one, which is 30 gallons, okay? So when I take 15 over 30, they have a common factor of 15, okay? 15 divided by 15 is 1. 30 divided by 15 is 2. So my answer would be 1 gallon to 2 gallons, okay? This would be my ratio right here, 1 gallon to 2 gallons. And Garcia, I forgot to box your answer, but we're doing that now, okay? We did reduce it to the lowest term, so that was our final answer right there. Number two says a bucket has 4 different colors of balls. The ratio of blue balls to red balls is 3 to 7, and the ratio of green balls to yellow balls is 9 to 21. The question is asking, are the ratios of blue to red balls and green to yellow balls equivalent or equal? Are they the same? On each side of the equal sign, are they the same? Well, we got to figure that out. We have to write the first ratio, which is 3 over 7. We have to, on each side of the equal sign, we need to set it equal to 9 over 21, okay? So then we write 9 over 21. Now we need to figure out, this is already 3 to 7. 9 over 21, we can still simplify that fraction. We're going to divide by 3, which is a common factor that 9 and 21 have in common, okay? So 9 divided by 3 is 3. 21 divided by 3 is 7, okay? When you look at both of those, I set 9 over 21 equal, which is 3 to 7, it's equal to 3 to 7. So yes, the answer is yes, they are equal. Okay? And I boxed my answer. Number 3 says, Mark has a bag with 120 coins. The ratio of pennies to nickels to dimes is 2 to 3 to 7. How many pennies, nickels, and dimes are in this bag? Well, if I take 2 to 3 to 7, I multiply by 10, 2 times 10, 3 times 10, 7 times 10. I came up with 20 to 30 to 70, okay? And I use 10 because 10 is a common factor between, it's a common factor of 120 and 20, 30, and 70. And when I reduce 120, and 20, 30, and 70, I get 2 to 3 to 7. Okay? So my answer would be 20 pennies, 30 nickels, and 70 dimes. This is the final answer I'm going to box right here. Okay, does anybody have any questions? Okay, so I want you to please pay attention. I'm going to let you take your math journal home. Okay? Remember all these notes we've written, these practice problems, I want you to refer back to them for your homework assignment, okay? Now class, Crystal will be handing out your homework assignment. It's on ratios. The problems on this assignment are very similar to what we have done on the board, the word problems, okay? And I do expect them to be turned in as you walk into the classroom tomorrow. You will set your backpacks down in the bin and you'll be asked to take out your homework and turn it in into my little cubby for homework. Okay? Are there any other questions? Okay, so today, class, we learned about rates and ratios. Y'all did an excellent job on participating.